This is the new Nokia 7 Plus.
In 2016, the Sri Lankan rupee depreciated 3.9% against the US dollar, while last year the Sri Lankan currency devalued 2.5%. Yesterday, the Sri Lankan rupee hit a record closing low, weakening for 5 out of 6 sessions, as dollar demand from importers and banks surpassed selling of the greenback by exporters early in the day. The rupee has fallen 0.9% so far this week and weakened 2.7% so far this year. Dealers said they expect the rupee to gradually weaken and face higher volatility this year due to debt repayments by the government.
The debt stock remains what the debt stock was and is. It is expressed in United States dollars and not in rupees. Also, appreciation and depreciation of the rupee is based on market forces. Of course, sometimes people with various untested or archaic or political ideas attempt to forcibly maintain the value of a currency at a particular level. This policy of holding the rupee at 112-113 cost us almost $4.2 billion. Ultimately, what happened after losing $4.2 billion? The rupee depreciated to 132.35. So these are not sustainable solutions. The only sustainable solution is to increase exports and increase the real earning of US dollars. The central bank has almost $10 billion in foreign exchange reserves currently. If we want to intervene, there could not have been a better time to intervene.
Meanwhile, Foreign Minister of Finance Ravi Karunanayake said that the monetary policy should go in line with the fiscal policy of a country.
But a monetary policy must go in line with the fiscal policy. But here, now the officials try to basically make things out as if everything is good when the political implications are far greater. We must bear in mind that every 1 rupee devaluation has an impact of 30 billion in impact to the budget. Likewise, a 1% interest rate increase has an impact of 50 billion to the budget. Now, these are not something that you project. It so happens at the time of payment, if the rupee is at 160, then so be it that for what was projected 153 at the start has a 7 rupee impact. So, without doing anything to the country, you have 210 billion added on to the state coffers. So, these are the inimical things in trying to run an economy. If they were independent, impartial, they should have been carrying out this, then we wouldn't have had this impact now.
Meanwhile, UPFA MP Chandimavira Kodios expressed views on the depreciation of the rupee.
I can remember the time the Hambantota port issue came up. We were told at that time by the central bank officials and the other advisors was that if the government doesn't proceed with the Hambantota transaction, that the dollar will go up to 160. Hambantota was proceeded on that basis. But now look at what has happened. What we explained, or rather opposition at that time, has materialized. The position of the central bank and the advisors to the prime minister has failed. The economy is really suffering. So in this context, it is very clear that this government doesn't have a clear direction.
Meanwhile, media spokesperson of the Essential Food Commodity Importers and Traders Association, Hemika Fernando, said that due to the international price indices for essential food commodities remaining at all-time low levels, there will be no impact on commodity prices in Sri Lanka.
Though there has been an increase in the American dollar by a percentage of 1.5% when compared to last month to present, there will not be any price increase for any of the essential food commodities which we sell out in the wholesale market to the public. The international price indices for most of these food products are at present in all-time low levels. It is extremely satisfactory situation where our country is concerned. But in the long term, if the dollar keeps rising, the pro rata cost that is attributed by the increase of US dollar will come into effect.